Welcome to Casual Fridays, where we speak to dynamic people. Today we are speaking to Nthabiseng Tlaka, who is a student journalist on Media 24, a disability advocate, and also a disability employment recruiter. Welcome, Nthabiseng.
Thank you so much for having me.
I'm happy to have you.
Yes.
So, tell us a bit about your journalist journey with Media 24 and disability.
Okay, so I started the Media 24 Disability program in 2019, where it was a group of students that wanted to advocate for inclusion for disability people. And so in the program, we learn about how to journalize articles to bring awareness to society. And we also published, so each one of us had opportunities to publish three articles. So I published the articles, and people received my articles very well. And I was happy that I was able to also be inclusive of invisible disabilities in my articles. So currently I'm also part of the Media 24 program, where we are trying to establish businesses for disability awarenesses.
Cool.
Yes.
Okay. And your disability advocacy. Yeah. Can you tell us a bit more about it?
Okay, so in 2015, I was diagnosed with a rare condition called Guillain-Barré syndrome. I was physically impaired and not able to function. I was wheelchair bound and I couldn't do anything for myself. So since from then, I've recovered, and what I do now is I try to educate people who are born with and without disabilities to look out on rare diseases that can cause disabilities. So in doing so, I became part of Casual Day, the NCPD. I'm currently the national ambassador, and I've done interviews. I've done the best that I can to try and educate society about disabilities and how to treat people with disabilities, and also the government. I've been trying to reach out to the government to try and make them aware of the scarcity of employment for Kenyans with disabilities, and for the government to be able to train and put the right machines, braille machines, and all sorts of things that are needed by disability candidates in the workplace.
That's awesome. But on that note, this is speaking of a casual day. I wonder if people know this, but if they don't, please. As you can see on the screen, I have a digital sticker. If you want your own digital sticker, please go to the link below in the description. It's casualday.co.za, and you can get your own personalized digital sticker for 20 rand.
Yes. And they can also get stickers for their families. So you don't have to get one sticker. You can get as many stickers as you want. And the proceeds are obviously going to support all people with disabilities in South Africa. Mm-hmm. So yes, thank you so much.
Okay, yeah, thanks, Doise. So can you tell us maybe about any highlights that you had for your journalistic career? Any interviews that stand out for you?
So currently I've written about, I would say 10 articles, published 10 articles as a student. And highlights were when I published an article about a young lady called Matlatsi Mthiba. She has a rare condition called endometriosis. So it's not really known by society. It's a condition that affects women. So in a sense where they can't function. So basically endometriosis is a condition where women's reproductive system is not functioning well, and by this it affects their daily living, their daily activities. They have excessive pain during their period,
cycle.
Yeah. And so when I published this article, there were a lot of ladies that came to me and actually applauded me for standing out and seeing that endometriosis is indeed an invisible disability that stops lives from functioning well. And so that was my highlight. I look forward to publishing more articles on invisible disabilities that are not spoken of in the media.
I got educated. I didn't know it all. I didn't even know what it means. And tell us about your idea of helping persons with disabilities get employed.
Okay. So I've been doing recruitment for the past 2 years on a voluntary basis. And the idea that I have now is to start my own NPO, where I'll be doing employment consultancy and helping businesses to also be compliant and also to help them in employing disability candidates.
Awesome.
Yes.
Okay. If there's any personal disabilities that would like to make contact with you regarding job creation, how can I make contact with you?
So candidates can always reach me on my social platforms. On Instagram, it's Nthabi, it's at Gondi_Nthabi20. And on Facebook, it's Nthabi Gondi with an Q. And I'm also reachable on WhatsApp. My WhatsApp contact details are 062-7273-671. And for companies that are looking for my services, I'm also reachable on the... those platforms, and my email address is underneath. Thank you.
Awesome. There you have it. If there's any person with disabilities that would like to look for work, please do make contact with Nthabi. And yes, see you on next episode on the next Casual Fridays. Thank you.